expectations? Like, how do you give advice to these?
All right, my expectations for this event, Best in Drag Show, are high. And I've got to keep these gays in check, and I'll tell you why. Because they keep me in check, all right? So they know that I'm going to deliver my most inappropriate material tonight, and I'm happy to do it. Because these are men that have been in heels higher than mine for a very long day. And I don't know if you know this, but they have fundraisers even for their costumes. And 100% of the proceeds go to Aid for AIDS. I actually made a donation online, so people can make a donation online as well. Get the miles, you know. But also, this is just a night where people let their hair down. And in my case, my face. Hair down, because that's what this night is about. It's about really poking fun at the genre of drag and having fun with the political correct nature of the LGBTQIA2 community, because tonight we actually are not politically correct. We're just having fun.
Is there any particular favorites that you have? Any stars that you love and adore?
I'm not going to say, how do you choose between Tsunami and Tasty Freeze? You know, and I've been here since they had Anita Fix, Chenille Bedspread, Quesadilla. You know, I've seen all these girls come and go. So I'm looking for quality and a fearlessness.
Nice. Well, tell us a little bit about you. Anything you have coming up? Anything exciting we should know?
I have a new CD called Look at My Butt Crack. And if nothing else, you should download it just to see the beautiful Tyler Shields photo of my butt crack. It's very tasteful, but I'm shamelessly hoping to get another Grammy nomination.
Yeah, you got one.
I finally won this year. But, you know, as a woman, I want to, you know, break records, and I feel that we have to work harder and jump higher, so I wouldn't mind a second one at all.
I would just say, like, it's the year of the booty, so the butt crack.
You know. There you go. I am like a middle-aged white Nicki Minaj. Everyone wants to see my booty. They're all talking about it.
I'm judging.
Wow.
Yeah.
Are you excited?
Very excited.
Have you ever done this kind of thing before?
Never done any of this before.
Do you have any expectations?
Zero. No, I'll probably be the easiest. Yeah, I don't know how it works, but I'm pretty much going to be a very lenient judge.
Yeah? So. Well, it's going to be, you know, it's a whole AIDS awareness. Is there anything that inspired you to say yes to the event?
It's for a good cause, and it seems like a good time. So those things usually, if those two elements are part of it, I'll be there.
Might as well, right?
Yeah.
So the show's doing great?
Show's doing good. So we're
what season is it now?
We're in fourth season. We have a couple more episodes till the end of the season, and then we see if we get picked up for a fifth.
Any surprises we should know about?
Surprises? No, I think the big surprise was that Breckenmeyer's character sleeps with my mom, Jane Seymour, which was an episode that I directed and he wrote. So yeah, it was kind of cool. The rest of the season, just usual antics of Franklin and Bash.
A judge tonight?
So excited. It's my second time at this event. It's my favorite event. I love it so much.
So what are some of the criteria you look for as far as best in drag?
Usually I start crying as soon as they walk out. I love it so much, and I love the spirit of the event and the organization itself and what they do, the Aid for AIDS, and how many people they support, supporting people with addiction, and it's just an amazing, really moving evening, and it's fun, obviously, but it's moving too.
Do you have any expectations on any winners or anything about this?
I just can't wait, though. I can't wait to see it.